Hey guys, so you may have heard something called modes and routines on your galaxy, but you don't understand how they would be useful, or you don't know where to begin with them. I had the same questions when I started, but don't worry, I got you. So today, I'm going to talk about what modes and routines are, the differences between them, and also show you how to set each of them up, plus a few tips to help create your modes and routines. Let's go. So first, what are modes and routines? In short, they are a way to automate settings on your phone. For example, if you wanted to automatically turn off Wi-Fi when you leave home, or turn on power saving mode at 20%. Modes and routines are created by setting conditions and actions. It follows a pattern of if conditions are met, then trigger the actions. Now that you have a general idea of modes and routines, let's dive into each of them in more detail. So routines, what are they? You can think of routines as setting what you want to override or what setting you want to add when a specific condition is triggered. So here are the details of how routines work. You can have any number of routines active at a time. The if condition part uses AND logic, meaning all conditions must be met in order to trigger an action. The trigger must be chosen as automated or manual. When a routine ends, you can individually choose what happens for each action. Inactive routines will appear as a notification message. So next, what are modes? You can think of modes as a general mood or scenario. For instance, what settings should be active when you are at work or sleeping? Here are the details of how modes work. Only one mode can be active at a time. The if condition part uses the OR logic, meaning if at least one of the conditions is met, then the action will trigger. A mode can be set to both automatically or manually turn on. All settings and changes are reversed when the mode ends. And an active mode will appear as an icon on the top right of the status bar. To summarize everything, here's a handy table I've created to help show the differences between modes and routines. So now, let's get into some examples. Let's start with creating a routine. So let's say I want to create a battery saving routine for when I'm not home and my battery is below 20%. I want it to turn on power saving mode and turn on dark mode. So first, we need to add the two conditions, which are the battery level below 20% and a place condition with a 0.1 radius of leaving my home address. Remember that in a routine, all conditions must be met in order to trigger the actions. For the actions, we will select power saving mode on and then dark mode on. For the end of the routine, we just let it to default to returning to their previous status. And that's it. We've created our routine. Here are some additional ways you might want to use routines. Auto-rotate screen when watching YouTube or Netflix. Turn off Wi-Fi when leaving home. Keep the phone unlocked while at home. Turn NFC on when Google Wallet is opened. And if you're stuck on what routines are possible, find the little compass icon at the top of the routine section, and here you can discover some great preset routines ready to go. Okay, next, let's create a mode. Let's say I want to create an exercise mode, because it's a place I'll be for a specific duration, and I will always be applying the same settings. I want the mode to turn on my Bluetooth, connect to my earbuds, and change my watch face when I'm at the gym, or when I start any exercises from the health app. So first, we need to create the trigger conditions, which will be when I get to the gym or I start an exercise from the health app. Remember, for modes, actions will trigger when at least one of the conditions is met. So we use the place condition for the gym and the other condition for an exercise, which will be during exercise, and I'll choose any workout. Now for our actions. We are turning on Bluetooth and connecting to my earbuds. then also changing the watch face. And that's it. So to summarize, this mode will activate when I'm at the gym or starting an exercise. My Bluetooth will turn on, connect to my earbuds, and change my watch face. When I leave the gym, the mode ends and all settings will return to their previous state. Here are some ideas for other modes. You can have a work mode to connect to your work's Wi-Fi and mute all volumes. You can have a sleep mode to turn off always-on display and fast charging at night. Or maybe a driving mode to turn location on, connect to the car's Bluetooth, and set Do Not Disturb on. Okay, now you know the difference between modes and routines and how to create them. Here are a few final tips to keep note of when you start creating your own. Routines over modes. Always start with routines first. As you learn and build routines, you will understand how each of them may fit into a scenario. Then you can see the potential of packing them into a mode. A majority of the time, a routine is all that you need. Not all settings can be configured in a mode. Routines have a lot more flexibility and customization. Lastly, you can download Routines Plus from the Good Luck app on the Samsung Store, which adds additional actions like read text aloud, touch macros, and most importantly, the ability to backup and restore all your routines. And that's your beginner's guide to modes and routines on Samsung Galaxy. If you're already using modes and routines, share some of your favorites down in the comments. If this guide was helpful for you, please make sure to hit that like button and subscribe so I know to keep these tutorials coming. Thanks for watching and see you in the next one.